Yes, good morning students. Today I am going to talk about the programming applications with threads. Okay, the programming applications with threads we are going to use for the two types of programs, that is thread implicit as well as the thread explicit. That what is the implicit? The implicit, which is nothing but whatever the task or whatever the like applications, okay, they are going to executed or they are going to happens internally, okay, internally by using the APIs. Okay, see, this method we are going to call it as the implicit method. The API, which is nothing but it is a application program interface, okay, which by using this interface, okay, whatever the task or whatever the program, they are going to execute it internally. Okay, that method we are going to call it as the implicit. But explicit, which is nothing but here, like what is that? The explicit method here, like all the task or all the threading, okay, they are going to executed. It is not internal, okay. Means all the threads or all the applications, okay, they are going to executed out of the program. So this method we are going to call it as the explicit method, and this explicit method they are going to manages or handles the many number of input output operations in the programs. So this is about the programming applications with threads. Then I'll move on to the what is the ownership what is the relationship between the thread and process. Okay, like here basically this programs, okay, it is going to contain it is going to tell us about the how the relations happens between the thread as well as the processes. Okay, now here you look at this diagram. Here we are having three units. Okay, the three units, which is nothing but one is processes, the second one is executions timeline and shared memory. Okay, these all are the three unit. Okay, it's very important units. Okay, which is going to handle the all the other threads. Okay, how the relations with relations will be happens between the threads as well as the process. You look at this diagram. In the shared memory, okay, it is going to like work as one of the interface between the process as well as the executions time. Here the shared memory, all the remaining memories, okay, or all the sub threads, okay, all the sub threads, they are going to interrelated to shared memory, means which is nothing but the multiple threads, they are going to executed in the single platform. Okay, then all after that, okay, everything they are going to stored on the memory, means all the programs or all the applications, okay, which we are which we are going to executed in the one platform or process platform, the everything it is going to stored on the shared memory. Then after that, in the process, okay, they have they are going to execute the main thread as well as the thread local storage, then instructions. Okay, the instructions, which is nothing but it is a program counter. Okay, the program counter which is going to holds the previous value of that particular address. Okay, see, this is about the program counter. Okay, means it is contains the previous instructions of the address, okay, which is going to helpful for which is going to help for the next instruction to executed as well as the store the particular value of the next instruction. So see, this is about the program in counter as well as the main thread. Okay, the main thread it is going to contains the running program. Okay, is identify identify the process which contains the at least one thread. Okay, see, whatever the running, okay, whatever the programs, okay, which is going to executed, okay, see, all the programs suppose I am going to executed n number of programs. Okay, in that at least only one thread or at least only one program, okay, which is going to identify, that program we are going to call it as the main thread. Okay, this main thread, it is going to support it to the process, or that main thread which is going to interlink to the process, so between the different interval time. See, you look at this diagram. Seeing diagram only you will got to know. See, the first thread, okay, it is going to execute it some amount of interval time. Then second thread, okay, that is also okay, it is going to execute it after 10 minutes of for the previous thread. Then third, okay, it is also after half an hour of the second thread, like that. Different interval time or different time, okay, they are going to execute it. Executed for all the programs, that every programs they are going to stored in the shared memory. That shared memory, okay, they are going to give back to the all the task or all the programs to the process. See, this is about the overview of the relations between the thread as well as the process. Then I'll move on to the next one. What is the thread APIs? The thread APIs, which is nothing but it is the application program interface threads. So here basically what are the thread APIs, okay, which we are going to use here. The first thread is POSIX thread, then second one is threading support in Java as well as the .NET. Then first of all, why the thread APIs, okay, we required. See, the thread APIs, okay, which is going to supports for the multi-threading for the various various according to the operating system as well as the specific programming languages, okay, they are going to used as well as the developed for the applications. And it is also possible to identify the minimum set of instructions or it may be programs, okay, it is commonly available for all the platform, okay, to implement that particular programs. And we are going to use, right, that I told, right, POSIX thread, then thread program, thread supports in Java as well as the .NET. Then what is the POSIX thread? Okay, the POSIX thread, which is nothing but, okay, the POSIX stands for Portable Operating Systems, Portable Operating System Interface for Unix. Okay, see, this is what the POSIX stands. Then the POSIX, which is nothing but, okay, it is a set of standards for the applications programming interface for a portable development of applications over the Unix operating system. The POSIX they are going to use for the for implementing the thread as well as the functionality of that particular applications or programs. And the standard address for the POSIX, okay, they are going to implement it on the Unix based operating system. Then what is the POSIX thread, okay, and what are the operations or what are the points they are going to follow in the programming? The first operation, that is thread identifies the local sequence. See, the thread identifies the local sequence of the instructions. Then after that, they are going to map to the sequence instruction to execute. After that, they are going to map that particular functions and that contains the sequence of instruction to execute. Then after that, they are going to create it as well as the terminated, and they are going to join the, means they are going to allow for the new thread. Okay, everything they are going to taken care. The thread has to determines the current conditions, okay, whether it is going to execute it or stop or terminated or waiting. Means so based on the decision or beta, based on the determinations, they are going to follow the all the thread operations. So these all are the these all are the different views, okay, they have support for the thread programming. Thread programming point of view. Then what is the this one? What is the threading supports in Java? The threading supports in Java, which is nothing but, okay, it is also used for the many Java programs, or it may be a .NET program, okay. Then C hash, okay, C hash, which is nothing but .NET, okay. See what it is tells means it is it is going to give complete informations or complete data about the .NET as well as the Java programs, and it is also provides